Every person on this planet has their own unique pair of eyes. I'd like to tell you the story of the eyes that changed this world. Remember these eyes.
Eye Origins is about a scientist named Ian Gray.
He's mostly interested in the evolution of the eye.
He kind of gets taken on a roller coaster ride of love and spirituality and science.
Karen comes in as his resident lab partner, and they're studying the human eye together.
Their research leads him on this journey where he starts to question science and spirituality.
He falls in love with this woman who has these magnificent eyes.
Can I take a picture of your eyes?
Why?
It's just something I do.
And then that person disappears, and all he has is a photo of her iris, and it's a series of strange coincidences that leads him to her.
I go to 7-Eleven, I buy some stuff.
11-11.
Lucky 11s.
I look at the date, it's 11-11. I look at the time, it's 11-11. I start to see these 11s everywhere, which then led me to you. Throughout the film, there's definitely a theme of coincidence and what is fate.
When I saw you that night, I had the feeling that I had known you. Like, we are connected from past lives. You know, the white peacock symbolizes souls being dispersed throughout the world.
Will you marry me?
Sophie? Sophie?
Sophie! Ah!
I think there's a part of you, when you had lost someone, that always think, what about if this person was here? Don't worry, we'll find each other again.
They end up finding out that the uniqueness of the human iris may be used to track the spirit through time.
Maybe the eye really is some kind of window to the soul.
There's a girl born in India with Sophie's exact iris pattern.
Impossible.
They found multiple iterations of the same iris patterns, which goes against everything.
It's a false positive, it's an error.
If I drop this phone a million times and one time it doesn't fall, that is an error that's worth looking at. You should go to India.
The whole movie is built around this one climactic scene that takes place in India.
I'm looking for someone. The thing is, all I have is a picture of their eyes.
This doesn't make sense. These are our eyes, but this isn't a face around me.
That's exactly why I'm looking for you.
What would you do if something spiritual disproved your scientific beliefs?